Hey there guys, this is Piper here, and welcome to another Rome Total Battle. So this is the second battle between GREEK-DIOMIDIS and GREEK-IRAKLIS against the HoS side of HoS Madgeh and HoS Aragon. This is from round 3 of the Great Games Tournament. So this was the 31k aspect of this round, and the score so far is 2-1 in favour of the Greek side. So the second, or the previous 31k battle, that was a win for Cleminus and Demidis. This matchup is actually going to be Macedon and Greece versus Carthage and Germania. So bearing in mind, factions can only get picked once throughout the whole round. That might be a strategic move by the HoS players. So go through the armies fast. Cleo's gone for all pike for Macedon. I think all these guys are gold. Most of them are gold. Some are one chev. And 6, Companion Cavalry, gold. Iraklis has gone for 6, Militia Cavalry, they're gold, and the rest are Spartans. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, so the rest are Spartans. So quite interesting armies, just by looking at them. Appears the HoS players have gone for skirmish armies. Germania has gone for, looks like they're all chosen Archer Warband. Yes, they're all chosen Archer Warband and 6 Cav or 6 Gothic Cavalry. I think they're all gold. I think some of them have 1 Chev. So 6 Cavalry and it looks to be all chosen Archer Warband. Aragon's gone for, again, similar at 6 Sacred Band Cavalry. They are fully upgraded, looks like, and the rest are Balearic Slingers. They are gold. And he's got 6 units of Sacred Band Pike. They are gold, 1 Chev. So that's the only melee infantry that the HoS side have, are these Sacred Band Spearmen. It can work out, but you have to remember that 31k is different from CDBB, it's harder to skirmish. The map's smaller and the unit size is larger than CDBB, or the map is the same size. It's because the units are bigger, it makes it harder to skirmish. So unless these archers can actually outflank, it's going to be quite hard to actually beat all these pike. Germania's pulling back the chosen archer warband. On the left hand side, looks like Aragon actually caught a unit of Javcav. I think they actually went in there for a charge versus the Slingers. They're down to 76. They'll come back from routing, but they won't be the same as before. They'll be a little bit less on morale. So these Archer Warband are on the right hand side. Again, the Archer Warband, they're actually pretty good on the stats as well. They're quite expensive for the melee stats. But if the HoS side can do a lot of damage with the arrows and still have troops at the end, they do have a shot at winning, but they have to do enough damage with the arrows at the start. Because the Spartan Hoplites and the Royal Pikemen are fairly good pike. Got the archers on the right hand side. They'll be looking to get some arrow shots in there. Again, keeping the cav in centre and trying to keep the pike facing the missile units. So we're going to do double speed here. Let's try and speed this up a little bit. This isn't as long as some of the previous battles, but it still is a fairly long game. So we're going to keep it on double speed and let's see what happens. So around the back, some more engagements between the Javcav and the Balearic. That unit's down to 7. Probably got a couple other kills somewhere else as well. They're down to 61. I'm going to keep it on double speed. moving forward, the chosen archers on the left-hand side. They'll be coming into range for the rear of the Spartans. Archer warband, they'll be firing the sides of the pike probably. Madgeh's got these guys fire it well off. He wants to manually select his targets. Archer warband are firing at the sides of the Spartans. Get some good shots in there. Dead Spartan right there. And let's play it right here. So good plays here by Cleomenes. They're pushing with the pike and they've actually caught that unit of chosen archers. Using the Jav Cav there, getting some good volleys in there versus the backs of the Chosen Archer Warband. The downside is the Blairax are getting shots in at the sides. It's another good charge there by the companions. And I'm going to drop Pike at the right time there. Madgeh is going to get his Gothic Cavalry caught by the Pike. Can he pull these Cavalry back round? They're going to route. So that's two units of Germani actually routing right there. Using the Jav Cav there to target the Slingers. That's a good play there by Iraklis. Can he pull back the Jav Cav before... So basically, that was really a good play there by Iraklis and Cleo working well together as a team. Use the speed advantage of the Jav Cav versus the Blairic Slingers. Those Gothic Cav came in and Cleo backed them up using the Companion Cavalry, so they actually routed there. And there's another unit of Gothic Cavalry actually routing. So these Gothic Cavalry, they're actually shooting the backs of the Spartans. They've got a lot of good damage there versus the Greek Pike. But the HoS side have lost a couple units of Chosen Archer Warband. And there's another one actually a little bit vulnerable right here. Let's put it on double speed again. So there's still 6 units of Sacred Band Spearmen. Still a lot of Chosen Archers right there as well. I think they've got Firewall off. And what are they doing? They are Firewall off as well. 3 more on the left hand side. But again, even the situation, it's not really the best angle. He's got a chance at shooting the companions. They don't have a shield. They're very vulnerable to arrows. But there's so many pike left for the Greek side. They don't want to waste too many arrows on cavalry and Jav Cav. They want to really use as many of the arrows as they can against the pike. So keep on double speed. The Sacred Band Cav are shadowing the companions. There's a unit of Gothic Cav in the back as well. Let's play it here. 2 Gothic Cav are actually over here as well. They actually caught that unit of Jav Cav. Quite a good play here by HoS actually. They're actually moving forward the cavalry. They're trying to really catch the companions. But instead of moving back and engaging the Cav, Cleo and Iraklis are now hitting the weak side of the HoS army, which is a smart thing to do. They could have come back and actually attacked the Gothic Cav and the Sacred Band, but they're making the smart play by attacking the weak side of HoS. So HoS basically put all the Cav on the right hand side, or most of their Cav, and they've left some units of Chosen Archers vulnerable. So really good play here by Cleomenes, really mopping up these Chosen Archers, and going to do the same here against those archers are in the back. Madgeh's really going to have to pull over some Cav to help his archers out. If all these guys route, it's going to be very hard for the HoS side to actually do damage to the pike. 6 Sacred Band is not enough to defeat all that pike. just a question of, can Cleo save his cavalry? I think he's going to get caught here. He's going to lose at least one unit, I think. There's still two at the back right there. Madgeh was actually hiding some units of berserkers around the back. So when I counted, I can only count 11 archer warband and 6 cavalry, which means that there was 3 units of berserkers. Another unit over there as well. So they're actually in heroic mode, where if they catch the companions, they'll do a lot of damage. It looks like the companion cavalry that was down here actually routed. They did a lot of damage to the chosen archers. Still 2 units of companions right here, and the HoS side are really wanting to take out these companions at the battle, because without that cavalry, it gives the HoS side the ability to outflank from all sides and really hit the pike with the archers. And again, smart move by Cleo breaking up his companions, making it more difficult for the Sacred Band Cav and the Gothic Cav to catch up. Still got the Berserkers right there, they're trying to do their best to catch up with the companions. However, it's going to be quite difficult for those units to catch up. Another chance here for Cleo to get a charge in there versus the chosen archers. Surprised that Madgeh and Aragon weren't able to catch that unit of companions. They seem to just move over here and stop. They're going to probably catch that unit of companion cavalry. There's enough units here to pull over. But again, I think Cleo really just wants to save at least one unit and maybe tire out the rest of the enemy cav. That's his other units of cav right there. And there's a unit of Gothic Cav at the back. So we're going to triple speed this. Again, like I said before, it's quite a long battle. Again, these guys have fire at will off. And that's really because they don't want to waste missiles at the fronts of the pikes. When you chase down archers with heavy cav, it's a little bit of a disadvantage, because it means that these pikes are going to push forward. The Sacred Band are very tired. They're not as effective now because they've been chasing down enemy cav and enemy archers. So these pikes are going to push forward, and they're going to try and, they really just want to kill the archers. They want to try and get kills on the Sacred Band spearmen, but it's really the archers they want to kill. Good play there by Madgeh, actually caught that unit of Jav Cav. Caught a unit of archers right there. Aragon's going to move back to units of Sacred Band. He's broken up his spearmen to make it harder for the Greek side to catch them. He's going to lose a unit there though. Because there's so many enemy troops, they've actually instantly routed there. They're going to lose all their men from that unit. And that's the other unit of Militia Cav actually routing. Still got that other unit of Companion Cavalry. They actually caught that unit of Bleric Slingers. Again, I'd say the advantage is definitely within the Greek side. The HoS side have lost a lot of missiles. They've lost a couple of units of pike, and I think they need more than this to actually beat all the pike. Even if they outflank from all sides and then get some shots in. The Sacred Band are gold. A lot of the raw pikemen are gold 1 chev. They have very good stats. So if they make a massive box, it's quite hard for a lot of those missile units to actually beat the pike box. But like I was saying, the Sacred Band are now exhausted. The Sacred Band cavalry, the Bleric Slingers are tired. We're going to put it on double speed. Skirmishing is a lot harder in 31k than CDBB. So we're going to triple speed this. The Pike are moving forward. Plate here, that's the Berserkers. They're going to get caught by the Spearmen. That's going to make them... They're actually broken because they would have actually turned back round and gone into heroic mode. But because there's so many enemy pike right here, they actually routed straight away. And they're actually fairly expensive. I think they're actually at least 3 upgrades. So that's that unit of Berserkers taken out. Good use of the cavalry from Cleaminess. And again, if the Greeks I keep on pushing, the HoS side have to pull back. They don't really have enough archers round about. If they fire at the fronts of the pikes, they're not going to do too much damage. They're not going to do enough damage to defeat the pike. So there's a unit of slingers on the right hand side. Some cavalry in the backs. Some more slingers on the left hand side. So a lot of the enemy, or the HoS chosen archers are exhausted. A lot of the slingers are exhausted as well. Well, those slingers are actually fresh. They're very tired. Those chosen archers are very tired as well. So let's put it to double speed now. They tried putting the pike into loose. They're going to keep the pike in tight formation and just basically charge down as many archers as they can. There's still two units of berserkers on the left hand side, and there's some archers around the back as well, and some more slingers. Again, like I was saying, a lot of these missile units are actually very tired. Having so many pike charge them down, a lot of them become very scared of the enemy numbers. Like, these pike are getting really close to those chosen archers. They're very tired. They might start to waver. And there's a charge there by Aragon versus those raw pikemen. Play it here, actually. Some charges are in the back by the HoS cavalry. They were trying to go for some kills on the Spartan hoplites. Clea was actually able to catch that unit of chosen archers. They were exhausted. She meant two things. They had lower morale and they couldn't run as fast. So they got caught by the raw pikemen who are actually winded. So I don't think they're going to rout off the field, but they've been reduced in number and they will come back with less morale. Again, we're going to put it back to double speed. Again, when you have so many archers, it's basically just a case of try and use up all your ammunition first and then going for the attack. Obviously, with the Greek side pushing with the pike, it's making it difficult for these archers and slingers to get shots in. Archers are now fired at will. And this is what tends to happen a lot of times when you bring so many archers. Sometimes you lose a lot of archers and you run out of options and you have to use your archers in any way you can. So these slingers are actually firing at the fronts of the pike. So the battle is definitely in favour of the Greek side. They're pulling back the slingers right there. Still a unit of slingers right there as well. And still got the two units of berserkers. I don't know how effective these berserkers will actually be. I don't really know the logic of these berserkers. It might have been better for Madgeh to have brought Knight Raiders if it was for the fear effect. In this sort of matchup when you have so many pike, I think Knight Raiders would have been the better option, because they're cheaper and do the same amount of damage to the morale. So we'll check out how many pike are left. Is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pike are left. I think some of these are actually reducing number. One is actually down to 80. They're going for some shots in there versus the companion cavalry. They're down to, what, 6? Heraclius has moved forward his Sacred Band pike. The Greek players have become separated. Opportunity for the HoS side to take advantage. So it's that unit of archers, they're actually 66, they were the ones that routed before. It's a good possibility these archers will rout again if the Sacred Band can catch up. Good play there by Heraclis, catching that unit of Gothic cavalry. Getting quite close to being caught there. I don't really know what Madgeh can really do here. These Sacred Band, these Spartan Hoplites are gold. Very, very powerful. Again, it's just a question of time before they get caught by the pike. Says wavering, the cavalry are going for the charge, they're going to rout. So they've actually routed right there. They're going to save the unit of Blurred Slingers. The other two units of Chosen Archers are actually shooting the backs of the Royal Pikemen. And that's a unit of Chosen Archers taking out the game. Gonna use the companions, trying to reduce those archers, make sure they don't come back. I think the Greek side probably want to reform a little bit. The HoS side are really moving over their cavalry, they're actually flaming the pikemen. This is probably going to be their best shot actually winning this game. Once these Spartans and the Royal Pikemen actually reform, it's going to be quite hard for the HoS side to actually break that. They've lost a lot of Chosen Archers. They don't have that many missile units left actually, and a lot of the Sacred Band aren't actually full strength. It's 38. Those two are 54 actually. The Gothic Cavalry, 41, 37, 33. Quite a good play here, moving through the Spartan Hoplites, trying to really push back these Chosen Archers again. The Greek side are really trying to, right here they're spreading out their pike, trying to catch any missiles they can, which is a good idea, but the downside is they've actually broken up their pike, which has meant that these Royal Pikemen are a little bit vulnerable now. If they catch the Berserkers, it'd be quite useful. So I think Cleo probably box up right here, try and defend those Royal Pikemen. And again, it says distraught over the number of enemies. These Berserkers won't do too well actually, even though they've caught the pike out of formation. There's so many Royal Pikemen here. They've actually been freaked out about that, they're actually routing, and the other unit will probably rout as well. That's another unit of Sacred Band actually routing. So that's both units of Berserkers taken out. We've got the four units of Spartans moving back from the rear. Again, if if these pike move forward, they're going to catch these units of Blair Slingers and potentially some Gothic cavalry. On the left hand side, we've got that unit of Sacred Band pike they've actually routed. They're going to catch another unit right here as well. They're definitely going to rout once these Spartans catch up. It's difficult for Carthage to actually use the pike now because there's so few of them. It's quite difficult for example, when that pike unit went up, it's fighting what, 14 pike. It gets freaked out by the enemy numbers. Charge here from the Gothic Cav against the pike. They've actually turned around at the right time, dropped their pike and caught the Gothic Cavalry. That's actually the general unit for Germania as well. So now the Spartans have actually reformed with the Royal Pikemen. Charge here from the Gothic Cavalry. They're going to get caught by the pike again. They just absolutely destroyed that unit of pike, of Gothic Cavalry rather. That unit of pikemen was actually routed. So there's another unit of Sacred Band spearmen. They're exhausted, they're fighting warmed up Spartans. They're definitely going to lose that battle there unless the HoS they can bring over some cavalry, which is what they're doing there. There's another unit of Spartans chasing down those Blair Slingers. So the four units of Raw Pikemen, they're actually trying to chase down the cavalry. Again, potential here for a hammer and anvil against the Raw Pikemen. Good play there by the Carthage player. It's probably time for the Greek side to actually reform now and make the pike box. Done a lot of damage to the chosen archers and I'm taking out virtually all the pike. There's a unit of pike right there. So they're gearing up for a hammer and anvil with the cavalry. I don't really feel that Cleo wants to engage here because he knows that there's cavalry in the back as well. That's the Sacred Band actually routing. So good play there by the HoS side. They managed to catch that unit of Royal Pikemen, but they've been caught by the pike coming over. There's actually a battle over here as well versus the other unit of Sacred Band spearmen or pikemen. Cav charge went in there against that unit of Royal Pikemen. They actually routed, but suffered a lot of damage to the Sacred Band Cavalry. Another charge coming here against the sides of the Royal Pikemen against pretty much only cavalry. So a defeat is virtually a certainty, says on the stats. The rear charge there from Madgeh helped the spearmen a lot, or helped the Carthage side a lot. But a lot of these Gothic Cavalry are very tired. It looks like we're kind of 50-50 here. Another charge's gone in there against the Royal Pikemen, but as Aragon submitted defeat. There's still quite a lot of archers scattered about. There's a lot of chosen archers down there. Some chosen archers over here as well, and a fair amount of slingers. So a little bit of a premature admit right there. But again, like I was saying before, I think it would have been very difficult for the HoS side to actually pull that back. Well played to the Greek side, good use of the pike, good use of the teamwork, and again I think the changing point in the battle is when the HoS players brought around their cavalry, Cleo and Iraklis moved over their Spartans and their companions, which started off basically hitting the chosen archers and the Blair Slingers. So thank you for watching this battle, stay tuned for more videos, another two battles still to come in this round 3 of the Greek Games. The score now is 4-2, 4-1 in favour of the Greek side. Stay tuned for those. This is Piper signing off.